Very, very good evening, friends. This side, Rahul Magan here is a Group Chief Executive Officer, Treasury Consulting, and also a venture capitalist. As we speak, on 4th December 2020, I am having a very great news for you. You know that I am always a person who believe in challenging the status quo. Not status quo, but basically the kind of status quo which is being given to us. And the most important status quo which I always challenged is the degree culture. Unfortunately, lot of certifications is around, lot of degrees are around, lot of courses are around, but the kind of knowledge we are having is like 1800 knowledge. Do you know, guys, I already told you that more than 500,000, which is 500,000 jobs already being reduced in the banking system in the last 6 years. And they are only in Europe and US. God knows how many in Asia, India, Singapore, Australia, Hong Kong, Dubai. God knows, no one having any data of that. But I'm sure the number is not 20K, 30K. It is more than 100K or 200K. And as the world is moving towards digitization, as the world is moving towards app-based banking, you know how much damage is set in the banking system. But who cares? In the sense like, no one cares. Because media don't speak, people don't want to listen. That is another problem. Our objective to be a bank would definitely get done somewhere in another 2 to 3 years. And we would definitely be a bank in London, that I assure you. And if we turn out to be a bank, what kind of services we would offer, that you also understand. And the kind of competence we are having in the financial market, you always understand the kind of competence we are having in the financial market. More importantly, you also understand the most important thing, which is, you know, I would say, I always love that people should spare maximum knowledge in the society. Always share lots and lots of knowledge in the society. I think that the great nuclear scientists like Einstein, our ex-prime minister, our president, ex-president, Sir Dr. Abdul Kalam, they also believed in the same thing. They also spared lots of knowledge in the society, and even till their last day they were working. And they never felt that they are like nuclear scientist or a president, but they always gave their maximum to the society. I know there are many who always love to disregard these things. There are two kind of critics we have in the world. Now, one kind of critics is those people, those who really have something and they can critique. Example, if Warren Buffett will put some comment to me, I will surely have this word to word, because he proved his mettle, his credentials over the period of the time. We should not forget the modest beginnings he made and now where he is. Even at the age of 87, he is working like, I think dedication is a little less word to be used if I say when it comes to Steve, Mr. Warren Buffett and Mr. Bill Gates. The richest man of the globe, Mr. Bill Gates, is still completely dedicated to Microsoft. And I don't see any reason why he cannot say that, hey, I'm on a holiday. It's enough. Since I was 26, I am working for Microsoft, and now it's over 80. I think it's enough. I know that like Steve, he would love to work till the last day and committed to Microsoft, and Mr. Buffett would also. So they are kind of critics. If they come and comment, you have to listen. There are another kind of critics, and they are the bureaucrats. They are the government officials. They are those people, those who have no credentials. Just like on our YouTube channel, we always get comment from the people, those who even not uploaded a single video on YouTube, and they come and comment against us. Hey guys, you do not have a single video on the YouTube. You do not have a credential of even uploading a single video on YouTube, and you are challenging somebody who hold more than 4,600 videos and expected to shot around 5,000 plus videos in 2021 itself. if God is kind and God is really kind, we would end up 2021 with more than 10,000 videos only on the YouTube. I know that 2021 would be a challenging year for us. Challenging year in the sense like there are so much happening around, market is turning very volatile, and today, as we speak, market breached all records. Don't ask fundamental guys. Market breaks all records. And gold is going reverse. Japanese yen reverse, euro reverse, no fundamentals. Go to hell, fundamentals. We do what we wanted to do. If you can track us, track. If you do not track us, let it be. Considering all this mess up, I think that 2021 would definitely be an interesting year, and Tashi Consulting is really committed to it. We know that the volatility level in 2021 will rise, and maybe significantly rise. It would be difficult for most of the people to perform in 2021 because the kind of volatility level would very rise, and especially when Biden will take up as a president of United States of America officially. The day Biden will take up as a president of United States of America, I'm telling you, lot of political and geopolitical volatility will come into the picture. And once it comes into the picture, you will see that situation would be highly volatile in nature, and it would be difficult even for the hedge funds to make sure it. And one of the important things how we measure volatility is definitely via media. Media is of two types. One is definitely the print media, and another is the business media, basically the business channels to whom we watch. Without quoting the name, there are many business channels we have across the globe. India, US, Europe, there are many business channels, and till what level of authenticity they hold, we all understand, to be honest, without quoting any name. Treasury Consulting is already committed to launch on Maxim, and the work has started, and hopefully by first week of January, we would be holding the we would be launching our first monthly Maxim. It would on FX, fixed income, financial markets, and all. It's a kind of magazine where we throw numbers. Unfortunately, there is no magazine we have in the world those who throw numbers. But we would definitely love to throw numbers, to be honest. Another thing which is very important is, as I told you, that media is having two components. One is definitely the print media, and one is the, I would say, the business media. And they are the real culprits because they have standard objectives. And they are always ready to work on their objectives. Whether the company is right company, wrong company, fake company, like we have saw that many penny stocks are like fundamentals. No, even in this show, which is their, the show on the Z Live, I'm for Harshad Mehta's show on the Z Live. Suchetna Dalal, basically the lady who worked as Suchetna Dalal in this show, she showed to her team member that, hey guys, this is the penny stock company. See, the company is really not working, it is closed, you know, and see the stock. And by the way, this is only a web story. In the reality, there are many penny stocks, those who have no sales, zero sales, but they are like, anyone dare to ask any question? Not at all. If you ask question, the fake people come on the YouTube and they started criticizing you. That's more important. And we have seen several such cases in the recent past when the fake penny stocks are like, what fundamental guys? You really do not know. What is company? What is company credentials? What is company up to? What exactly? I always of the belief that the penny stocks is, not always wrong. No, not at all. Penny stocks is not wrong, guys. Penny stocks rather a very good opportunity to invest because due to some financial crisis, some lack of leadership, some non-marketing strategies and zero focus, they are not able to reach like we are having big banks and big companies. Small people, right? Not sharp people. But they have potential. There are still many penny stocks, those who I would say small, but they have potential, guys. They hold sales. They are profitable companies. They are not loss-making companies. You can check their financial statement. They are completely profitable. You cannot say that this company is fake. Hey, guys, they are a profitable companies. But unfortunately, what is the mindset? The mindset people have created, if penny stock is rising, it means that it is a fake rally. I agree. But do we even bother to understand that why this penny stock is rising? I'm not quoting any name, but we knew that in this 2020, several penny stock grew by more than 1500%. And I was like, guys, what is the fundamental behind 1500% rise? Tell me one fundamental. And I was looking at many groups or many advertisements on the social platforms, and I don't know how come they are advertising this. They're calling themselves as multi-bagger platforms. You open Google and see the multi-bagger, right? They claim that their multi-bagger is 500%, 600%, 700%. I'm saying, hey guys, first of all, please explain me what is multi-bagger. And why you have made a term called multi-bagger. And why other people are going with the same notion which is called multi-bagger. There is nothing called a multi-bagger. Sometimes you have a stock due to financial conditions, not sharp people, operational efficiencies, government regulations and many other things, they become small until they get a notice of a big corporate. But eventually they get, and they become big when the people see them. Example, see the YouTube. In the YouTube, you will see that there are many videos, those who are very great videos. I personally know many people, those who make very good videos covering the life, the motivation and all. But few channels, two or three, without quoting the name, even if they publish anything, they get 1 million views. And you know how they work, to be honest, how exactly it works. Very recently, there was some kind of stuff you can see on the YouTube when several great celebrities accepted that they got paid subscribers. They paid for the subscriber base. End result, Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram, Facebook, WhatsApp, whatever video they post, it's like same as the scene with penny stock. Exactly. Cent to cent is the scene with the penny stock. And what is that? Pretty simple. Simplistic approach. There is a standard lobby whose objective is to make sure that this penny stock to rise. Whether this penny stock is having any functionality, any business model, they are in profitability, their financials are available in public domain, go to hell. We just need to increase this penny stock. And retail investor will entangle in this web and they feel that, oh, this penny stock is 1 rupee, now 2 rupees, now 3 rupees, now 4 rupees, now 5 rupees, 15, 20, 25. Buy this. And in our foreign exchange, there is a word called panic buying and panic selling. Panic selling, we recently saw Lakshmi Vilas Bank, when all of a sudden a moratorium letter came and people were like panic selling. I hope you read the letter recently written by one of the great personality, and it is circulating on the WhatsApp. I read this letter, it's a 3-page letter, and I think he wrote it in a nice way. To be honest, he mentioned all the points which, except few, which I love him to mention. Anyways, but more or less job done. So guys, we need to look everything holistically. I'm telling you that not all people are fake. Not all politicians are corrupt. Not all bureaucrats are corrupt. Not all soldiers are, I would say, traitors. Not all, I would say, scientists are great scientists like Einstein, Newton, Edison, and all the great scientists of the globe. Not all entrepreneurs are like There are exceptions. Unfortunately, when the exceptions become big in count, it looks like the whole pond and all fish in that pond is fake. But that is not the same. Penny stock is not a wrong option, but you need to do research on that. Hype is the most dangerous thing we are having in the life. And hype can create any mess. Like, see today, I don't know what banking fundamentals we do have, which I cannot see, make Bank Nifty as 30,000. God knows. Somebody sitting in any air-conditioned office in Mumbai or wherever must be planning 32,000. Because I get so many messages from the people, from startups, from companies. In fact, just now as we speak on 4th December, I got a message. I had a call with my friend to whom I worked during my treasury career. He told me that in an organization, there were around 5,000 employees, XYZ organization, and in last 1 year, more than 1,000 employees left. But if I look at in terms of Sensex, so penny stock is not bad. We really need to look penny stock in a rightest way. We really need to look penny stock in the way it should be. A holistic research is required in the penny stock. And in fact, why research? I'm always saying that do not buy anything without research. If you do not do research, you are bound to lose. It's not the stock. You are buying a home, do research. You're buying a car, do research. Except your marriage, because here you cannot do research. You know, said that the marriages are made in heavens, you know. If you are having some education degree, do some research. Whatever you do, have some research. Of course, intrinsic value plays a very important role in case of stocks. Whether you are buying a stock of Goldman Sachs, you are buying a stock of JP Morgan, or you are buying a stock of any small penny stock, intrinsic value play a very important role. Unfortunately, majority of the penny stocks are very closer to their intrinsic value. Or in some cases, they are very much lesser than their intrinsic value. And in some cases, they are available at throwaway prices. Example, CG Power. CG Power, when we analyzed the CG Power, it was like a great company. And we analyzed, we read through financial statement, we collated all the possible information in the public domain about what had happened in the Crompton Greaves, because of which, you know, several people asked to quit the board, what had happened. But did auditors came into the picture? No ways, forget it. Auditors will not come into the picture. Whatever fraud happened, auditors will never come into the picture. Yes Bank, PMC, you know, infrastructure leasing, Divan Housing, and maybe the futuristic scams, auditor will never come into the picture. This is very important. Considering this, Treasury Consulting decided to launch a video course on the penny stock. And this is the beginning. And in this video course, we would definitely be launching how to take positions in the penny stock. And of course, it's a training course, not a trading course. Like, you can buy this, sell this penny stock. I am a strong believer of the fact that penny stocks can make wonders, provided you know how to take them. Like, nowadays, there is a great hype about one NBFC. Which is that some private equity players have shown interest in some NBFC. And after every 10 minutes, I get one WhatsApp message. What to do, what not to do. Come on, guys. Private equity players are known of giving such statements. They love giving statements, rather. They always come in public domain and give one or another statement, so that the price become price fuel. And once the price fuel, you know how the lobby works. As simple as that. This is exactly how it happens. And it is not the first time that the private equity have shown interest. There are many a times when private equity and venture capital shown interest, and what had actually happened, you know. But that is why I'm always of the opinion that intrinsic value play a very important thing in the life, which we covered in our advanced equity valuation course. Intrinsic value is really, really important. If you're buying anything on intrinsic value, you would never lose until otherwise the company shuts down or company becomes winded it up. That's really, really, really important. And how to compute intrinsic value? I think every investor of the globe should come forward, should know how to compute the intrinsic value. Because I have hardly seen any certification course who stresses the requirement of understanding intrinsic value. I don't know, it's like a medical science when you are about to be a doctor, could be any doctor, gynecologist, brain, heart, or whatever, XYZ. And you can definitely read books, that's not a problem, but you cannot touch the body. Since you cannot touch the body, but you still get a doctor degree. It is like I am into a financial market, I am buying XYZ any share of any company, but the only thing I do not know is how to compute the intrinsic value, which is, by the way, is the most important thing. And end result, I always buy stocks which are either way above the intrinsic value, or where intrinsic values is saying, hello, I am only 100 rupees, the stock is 700 rupees, please buy. And that really matters to me because I never buy anything until it comes to intrinsic value. People may take markets to 30,000, 35,000, 45,000, even if Bank Nifty touch 50,000, I'm not bothered. To me, my intrinsic value is the most important thing. Rather, quartilized intrinsic value is the most important thing. Rather, indicative value is the most important thing. We are literally not bothered that whether market is 30,000, 35,000, 40,000, or maybe it would go to 90,000. Please, where this lobby want market to go, you please take this. I am not worried. That is what I always believe. So guys, the same is the story with the penny stock. I hope I explained what I wanted to convey. Hype is the most dangerous thing we are having in the penny stock. Most dangerous thing. Understand the financial statement of that company. Understand the intrinsic value. See whether this company holding any potential. See whether this company can be a futuristic source for any M&A. Example, there is a company XYZ who is a small company, low profits, XYZ. Can we research that this company might be end up as a potential source of acquisition in near term? Do not just go buy, 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 and you also buy, 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 and later on you see that, oh, a penny stock worth intrinsic value 5 rupees, I bought at 55 rupees and now it came to 5 rupees. What to do? I know. Many of those who really love me from their heart, they will go to the right end of the YouTube and say, down. Please, I'm not bothered. Because like our late president, Sir Dr. Abdul Kalam, like the late great nuclear scientist, Sir Einstein, like a living legend, Mr. Bill Gates, Mr. Warren Buffett, Larry Ellison, I will continue to share my knowledge in the public domain. And I will never relent from sharing my knowledge in the public domain. Because one thing which I always follow, the line of Einstein, and he said that my objective is not to teach everybody. Don't take it other way. My objective is to invoke one guy, he or she, in that class. Because if I'm able to invoke one guy in the class, he or she invoke other and this trend would continue. And at the end, I am serving a society which is more better than what it was. And that's what my role is. And that is what I'm doing. I'm literally not worried about critics. Please critic me once you have 4,500 videos. Please critic me once you have fixed income platform. Please critic me once you have apps. Please critic me when your commodity exchange would be live. Please critic me when you have over 200 plus courses. Please critic me when you have 5 plus video courses and more video courses are coming. Please critic me when you have a research desk who never sold a single stock and loss. Please critic me when you did researched on Reliance, Yes Bank. Please critic me when you have guts to come in public domain and say that SoftBank is going to get bust 2 years before when everybody was chasing SoftBank. Please critic me when you have guts to speak about any bank and raise issue on the big force about the disclosures, about the way they are disclosing the information. And please critic me when you have time out of your busy schedule to make a video for the public, and that too free. If all these qualities are met, then you're most welcome to critic me. But I assure to my critics that today we are 4,600 videos and 5,000 plus videos. We really try in 2021. And if not, then at least 4,000 plus videos, so that by 2021 end, we would be very closer to 10,000 mark, plus minus 500 to 700. This is Rahul from Pleasure Consulting. If you want any questions about our research desk, about our video programs, about our trainings, about our groups and anything, you're welcome to WhatsApp 9818485155. But guys, always remember that hype is the most dangerous thing we have in the life. There is nothing known as guaranteed. Research is the most important thing in the life. And degrees is always a waste of time, because the more we go degree, the less we're going to lose. Not having any degree. Every year, thousands and millions of kids passed out from different engineering or management institutions across the globe. Thousands and millions of students. But none of them able to create a profitable platform. None of them. Because we read this many pages books, but this many pages books do not have one thing, which is how to challenge a status quo. That I learned from him and I'm passing to the society, irrespective of critics. Have a great time, guys, and talk soon.